So I'm a teacher 7, Mr. Bear here. Today we're going to be working with the Chromebook stylus and working with an app called the Drawing app. We'll actually be creating a drawing there using the stylus. We're going to try it offline and try some other things there too and see some of the features. Also, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and see more content on technology and Chromebooks and other stuff. If you like these types of videos, please click on the thumbs up, comment down below, because I always love to read your comments. Alright, well, let's find this app. Hey, here I am in my Chromebook. Now from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the Chrome browser icon and then it will open up here into the new tab. Now right above me you see the apps. I'm going to click on the apps there and I'm going to start the Google Drive by clicking on that icon. And now I'm in my Google Drive. Over there where you see new, click on new and then go down to where you see more. After clicking on more, you'll notice the option that we have is Google Drawings. So click on Google Drawings and it opens up. And here we are inside of Google Drawings. Now this app does work offline, which is awesome. And we're actually going to see that because I'm going out to the desert today. First thing we're going to do is up at the very corner, I'm going to give this drawing a title. I'm just going to call it Drawing 12 for today. After giving it a name, you'll notice it says saved in Drive. Now if you've enabled offline support on your Chromebook, it's actually saving it onto your local storage as well as into your online storage. From there, I'm going to look at some of the features that we have here. So if I go File, you notice I can share it with others, I can go New Drawing if I need to, or actually go into my Google Docs, spreadsheet, or presentations, or do forms. I have open, so if I've done work in the past, I can open up an existing work. I can make a copy. I can email it. I can go ahead and actually do a download. So download, first off, is PDF. Now PDF, I use that a lot with work, so people use that as a way to send documents back and forth with business associates, and so that's your portable document format there. JPEG is a real common image format. Basically, any app can open up a JPEG image. And then we have PNG. Now, PNG is more of a high quality image, and you can use that with Adobe Illustrator. Scalable vector graphics is next, and again, you can use that with the Adobe Illustrator. We have the option to make this one available offline if I wanted to, and then I also have what's called the version history. I can rename it, move it, and I have many other options as you can see there. Under edit, I can do undo or redo, cut, copy, paste, or do those other options you see. Under view, I can zoom in to the work, show or hide the ruler, and then we also have guides, and I can snap to a grid or the guides, and I can do full screen. Next is insert, where I can insert an image, I can upload it from the computer or search the web if I'm online. Now if you're doing this offline, you'll notice that you don't have those options. All you have to work with are the images that you already have saved on your computer. I can insert a text box, a number of different shapes like the squares that you have there, or even the arrows, cutouts, and equations. I can insert a table, any type of a chart, or I can even import a chart from an existing spreadsheet. I can insert a diagram, word art, which we'll talk about that more in detail a little bit later, do lines, special characters, I can insert a link or a hyperlink, and if I'm working with other people on this project, I can insert comments. For formats, if I'm working with text, there's many different types of formats that are available to me, and I'll use those more when I'm working with text. The same is true with arrange. I can arrange my text or my artwork in different ways on my workspace. For tools, we have the all-important spelling and explore, dictionary, preferences, and others as you see there. And of course, we have help. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go to insert, and I'm going to insert a text box. I'm going to draw it out, and then I'm going to type in, here is the. Now, after doing that, I'm going to highlight my text. I'm going to change the font style from Arial to Lobster. Let's say that you're working with this and you don't see the font that you want. You can click on More Fonts. And when you click on More Fonts, you'll see many, many thousands of different fonts. What I'm going to do is I'm going to sort it by alphabetical. So alphabetically sorting there, and we have many, many A's. We literally have thousands of different fonts. So I'm going to go all the way down to the B's. And I'm going to choose Bangers. And I'm going to click on OK. There we are. Now from there, I'm going to change the font size. And I think I'm going to choose size 30. Then I'm going to change the font color. I'm going to make it a nice dark blue. Now that I have this done, I'm going to change the angle as well. So I'm going to take my stylus and press on the little circle that's above the text box, and I'm going to rotate it to about 345. There we go. After that, I'm going to go over and I'm going to click on Insert, and this time I'm going to go with WordArt, and I'm going to type in Drawing App. Hit the Enter key and it'll insert it into my workspace, and I'm going to rotate this to 345. I'm going to change the fill color there to be a nice dark blue, matches our other text. And I'm going to go back to the font selection tool, and this time I'm going to see that Bangers is right at the top since I just used it. Now I'm going to change the position and I'm going to drag it up. And notice that I'm doing that, you have these lines. These lines tell you when you're in the middle of your workspace. So when you see a crosshairs, that means you're exactly in the center of your workspace. I'm going to set it down right there. And then I'm going to move my text box a little bit. There we go. Now I'm going to insert a cube into my work. So I'm going to click on Shape. And I'm going to choose Cube. And I'm going to draw it out here. And then we're going to change the angle to about 345 so it matches everything else. And then we're going to click on the Fill tool and choose, let's see what color goes with blue. Maybe a really nice dark blue there. There we go. So as you see here, it works very easy with the stylus. And I love working with the drawing app. Now from this point, it's automatically saved into my Google Drive. And since I'm using it with offline support, it is saving it onto my Chromebook as well. But if I wanted to work with it in another app, I am able to click on File and then download it as a PDF, JPEG, PNG, or even as a scalable vector graphics. Now I'm going to take my Chromebook and go out into the desert. So here I am in the desert. Does the Chromebook work offline? Yes, it does. And yes, we truly are offline. So from here, I can actually go to the Google Drive, click on New, and then go down to More, and then Google Drawings. When you do that, it will ask you to name the document right away, so it'll be saved on your local drive. So that's the message that you get. So I'm going to name this one Drawing Offline, and then I'm going to click on Start Editing. So if I click on File, and then I see the option New, I can make a new drawing, document, spreadsheet, or presentation. I can open existing work that's already been worked on, but I'm unable to email it or download it because I'm offline. I am able to change the page setup as well. Now if I go to Edit, I can still have the option to undo, redo, and I can cut, copy, paste. I can do basic functions like that. With my view, I'm able to zoom into the document, show or hide the ruler, show the guidelines. I can snap to the grid or to the guides, and I can go full screen. Within the Insert menu and with the Image option, I'm only able to really work with images that I've already saved onto my hard drive because I'm working offline. I am able to insert a text box, a shape,
I'm still able to put in tables, a diagram, the line, or even a command. Okay, I'm now going to go in and actually do some work. So I'm going to add some text.
After adding the text?
So I'm going to go into Format, click on Text. You'll see that I have bold, italic, underline, strike through, superscript, subscript, size, color, highlight color, capitalization. So I'm able to change all that. I'm able to go into align and indent, line and spacing, bullet and numbering. I'm able to change the fill color, borders and lines, and then I do have other formatting options available to me with the text. So I'm going to rotate my text, and I'm going to change the font to Lobster. Now I'm going to insert another text box, and I'm going to type in Drawing App in there. I'm going to rotate it to the same angle as I did with the other text. Now I'm going to change the font size and change it to Lobster and bold. Now I'm going to spice it up a little bit and give it a color blue. And that's what I have so far with the drawing app, working with it offline. Now for the next topic. The next topic is working with a stylus on this Chromebook. So this Chromebook comes with a nice stylus, and you can use it with creating your app. Now, the way I'm showing it right now is I'm showing you the stylus and the screen, and it's a little bit difficult to work. Normally, you'd be sitting in front of your Chromebook and actually doing this work here, but if I go down here and I click on this tool down here, this is my stylus tools. I go down here and you notice that you have capture region, capture screen, create a note, laser pointer, or even magnifying glass. So you have many tools there and options that go with your stylus. And working with the drawing app, let's go in and I'm going to create another item in here. So I'm going to go insert, and this time I'm going to go word art. And I'm going to type in "so much fun." All right, so much fun. That looks good there. I'm going to press the enter key and put it in there. So now we have it. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change some of the aspects to this word art. I'm going to go over here and I'm going to change the border, make it 3px. Then I'm going to change the fill color, and let's make that a nice dark blue. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the font style. So I go to Arial. And let's go down to Lobster. And now I'm going to change the angle. So there you go, you can change the angle. Notice you have the little numbers that tell you exactly what angle you're doing. So I'm gonna go to about 345. There we go. And now everything lines up. So it says, here is the drawing app. So much fun, yay. And it was done with the stylus.
The port for the stylus is found in the front. Hey, so now you know how to use the drawing app with the stylus, and you can even do it offline. If you like these types of videos, please make sure you do click on thumbs up. And if you're new, please click on subscribe and click on the bell icon so you get notifications when we have new videos. Thank you very much, and bye-bye. All right, I'm going to show you what I used to create this video. I actually used my Chromebook in creating all of the material that was on the Chromebook. So there I was using Screencastify and Screen Recorder. And let me see here. That segment was towards the beginning. Where was it? There we go, yes. So all this area here, all these segments were created using Screencastify and Screen Recorder. And so that's all done there. And people have asked me, well, is the processors that Celeron N4000 processor, is that fast enough to actually process and work with the video? And as you can see, it actually did very good for its segment that it did. So it processed it and gave it to me there. I also use VideoPad Professional by NCH Software, but that's on a Windows machine. So I'll take the segment that was made by the Chromebook, and then I'll import it into the Windows computer and then do my other work with it there. And I didn't show this last time, but here's the raw footage. You can see some of the footage. I use video cameras to do that, professional video cameras. Then I have audio files I add, and these are the background music and sounds. So if we look, we have 5 audio tracks. And then am I using 5? No, I'm using 3 video tracks, it looks like. Yeah, 3 video tracks. And then these are all the segments down here. So a lot of work went into that. Here's the images that I used. So I'm using 53 different images. A lot of these were screenshots from the Chromebook and just importing them in. Some of them were my own photos. Like this is one of my own photographs there of the desert that is across the street. So if one of the comments is, hey, where's that desert? Well, it's the one across my street. And you just have to walk a couple hundred feet and you're basically out in the desert. Then I have the video recordings right here, my front, the end, and then I used part of that was part of the centerpiece there. And then I have the audio recordings. The audio recordings would be the voiceover that you'd see little segments here and there. Well, I just need to add something there to the audio. So it all works very well. I think the part that I had the most fun with was actually working out in the desert. That was a lot of fun. So let me get back there to one of their area. That's the desert across the street. And there's another segment there. So it was like I was looking straight into the sun, so I couldn't tell hardly where I was looking at because the sun was right behind the camera when I was doing this. So yeah, quite enjoyable there. Let me see, where's that footage? There's the footage. So this is the actual footage that goes in there. And when I was in my office, I was doing this footage. And I usually crop off the beginning and the end and just use the center part. And then here's another segment that was created on the Chromebook using that one was Screencastify for that app, and that was all made and processed on that Acer 511 Chromebook with the Celeron processor. A lot of work went into that. All right, hey, make sure you do click on thumbs up, and when you click on it once, it becomes a blue thumbs up. I think some people are clicking on it twice or something, and then it takes it off. I kind of noticed that behavior because I actually get to see when I analyze the video and what people click on, when they click on, and stuff like that. So anyway, thank you again and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.